Hi guys, and welcome back to our show, The Nest. My name is Suthuni Hall, and I'm the Events Officer of the Guild, and this is episode 9. It's the Melanin for me. I'm skin girl, your skin just like pearls. You're back against the
wild. I never tried you for anybody else. Hi everybody, my name is Kimel Marshall and I'm the Faculty of Culture, Creative and Performing Arts Student Representative on the Guild. And one random fact about me, that's English? One random fact about me is that I'm obsessed with the color purple.
The worst color on earth. In one word, what does Black History Month mean to you?
Skin. The color of my skin. The texture of my hair.
That's basically it
for me, because, like, you know, I believe that I have beautiful skin because of shea butter. Shea butter is amazing, and I believe that black hair is amazing as well. The coils, the curls, it's just it. Whenever I think about Black History Month, I just think about all, not even just my skin, all the different shades of skin that exist. The light skin, the dark skin, the extremely dark skin. Yeah,
that's a beautiful answer. So a similar question, I don't know if you follow this hashtag, but there's this new hashtag that's going around, hashtag Black Future Month. So what does, now that you're hearing it for the first time, what do you think that means to you now? So Black History Month, Black Future Month.
I guess, based on the fact that I'm not hearing it for the first time, I guess it's like acknowledging those who are capable of making themselves known in the future, like the young people of our generation who I don't want to be like senators or presidents or future choreographers and stuff like that. Who want to be there to make history in the future?
Now, I don't know for a fact what the meaning is, but I think that people sometimes associate Black History Month with slavery and all of the bad quote-unquote memories, like oppression and stuff like that. So I think that the hashtag was kind of like a movement to like see that we're moving forward, and it's more like an empowerment type of thing. Let's feel great about it. It makes sense. Okay, so what are three things you love to celebrate about being Black? You already said your skin, your hair, but it doesn't have to be physical. Three things.
Sorry, that's good skin. Okay. I don't say skin and hair, so
this is something. Yeah, I said it don't gotta be physical, but this is something I love. Black people. Bosses.
I love black singers. Like, especially, like, there's a difference when you hear a black singer sing.
There is. Like, it comes from pain.
Not only pain, they just carry the song a different way than any other person. So, like, Jennifer Hudson and Jasmine Sullivan, when they get out and start to sing, it's just be like, yeah, yes, connecting. And then when Ariana's come on, it's just be like, okay, cool.
Cool, you know, cute,
yeah,
cute or whatever.
It's Aretha Franklin, come on, you just be like, oh, woo. I love, or even Nina Simone, love me Simone.
Two more things. I said three.
Two more things. Oh shoot, crap. Food. A black person know how to cook. Like, I have not met a woman in my family that don't know how to cook. Like my grandmother, my aunts, my mother to a certain extent.
Sorry,
mom. Love her to cook food, but
one more.
One more thing. The creativity of black people, like, based on, you know, on social media, we always see that black people know how to make music out of anything. Mm-hmm. You know how to make something out of anything. So, like, when you just be sitting down randomly on a black person, will just get up and just be like, and then somebody else will just chime in and just create a random noise out of nowhere, and then boom, you got music. Let me sit down and then create art out of nothing, and you just be like, okay, cool. The creativity about people.
Good. Another similar question, right? One person, one black person that inspires you.
Harper Waters.
Tell people what. I know.
Harper Waters is a black ballet dancer with Houston Ballet, and he currently, right now, and for many years, has been transcending the view of male dancers in the world. Like, the man is dancing in heels, doing ballet in heels, and that alone had issues, and then everybody's just like, yeah, though, he know what he's doing, and he just stunning, amazing. So it's been like really nice to see him dancing and stuff like that, so it's made me feel inspired, like, more stuff too.
So let me just give a disclaimer, I don't know the answers to this question, these questions. But you should. I'm not gonna penalize you. We should feel bad if you don't. But I have the answers on my phone, but I actually don't know in my brain. So this is, how black are you really?
Okay, cool.
Right? Okay. Who was the first black woman in space?
Oh, you want me to get an answer? Come on, I know.
Okay. What is the name of a famous spider often spoken about in African stories?
Anansi.
Yeah, but I wouldn't have known that either.
Of course, everybody know the Akanda, my God. Anansi stories.
No, I would have said Black Widow. Anywho, which month is Black History Month?
Ask it. I want to hear it.
Which month is Black History Month celebrated in the UK?
October.
I didn't know there was another month.
Yeah, there is. I saw that like a time it was. I'm always randomly Googling stuff. So I was like Googling, when is Black History Month? And I see October came up popping up. Just like, for all 22 years of my life, I never celebrate Black History Month in October. So I was just like, okay, cool. Interesting.
That's crazy. Question for, wait, how many did he get right so far?
Two out of three.
Okay, so question four. Whose iconic speech included the words, I have a dream?
Martin Luther King Jr.
Her. What did Rosa Parks refuse to do in 1955?
She refused to get up from the back of the bus. Or she refused to give up a seat in the bus.
Yes.
Right, because she was supposed to go to the back. Right.
It was the right answer. Name three Caribbean islands.
Trinidad, Guadeloupe, Saint Lucia. Trinidad and Tobago. Yes, it is. Okay, let's change it then.
No, it is.
Saint Lucia, Saint Vincent, and Saint Kitts and Nevis.
Okay, next, Nelson Mandela was the president of which country?
I want to say South Africa.
You're correct.
Oh, okay, cool.
Okay, so which, no, you're not going to that one.
Ask it.
Okay, which famous black nurse died in London in 1881 after
honestly, first thing I got to my head was Nurse Ratched, and she's not even black.
Nurse who?
Ratched.
Who was the first black president of America?
Barack Obama.
Okay. Name three African countries.
We have Nigeria, we have Chad, and I'm going to say for my third one, Ethiopia.
I'm just gonna say yes. I'm gonna agree. Okay, name three of the fruits. Nah, you're not gonna have one.
Three of the fruits at what?
In Handa's basket. Who's Handa?
That's a good question.
From the book Handa's Surprise.
Oh, I don't know who that is.
Okay. Queen
Nefertiti. Nefertiti?
Huh.
Right, Queen Nefertiti.
Was queen of which country?
Sheba?
You wanna try again? Egypt. And I was gonna say this the last one, but no. Name the tallest animal living in Africa. Yes. And this is the last one. What is the next line in this Bob Marley song? You gotta know it. Don't worry about a thing.
Cause every little thing is gonna be alright.
You did. You got. He only got one wrong. Two wrong. Okay. So this is a next question, like a quiz question, but no words.
It's how this is my off day from school, and you got me doing a test.
No words. Actions. Right. How black are you really? What's that face that black people make when they hear something crazy? Wait. 1, 2, 3. Her. Okay. So I surprised Kemal today and I told him that on the show he has to teach me a dance. I called it
interpretive dance.
But I called it expressions. So he's gonna show us today how to do something slight.
Okay, cool. So you can imagine that you're holding a basket, right? Mm-hmm. So imagine you're holding a basket. So you're gonna step to the side and
oh.
your basket, yeah? Uh-huh. So you're gonna step and push your hip up. So you're gonna rotate the hip and come forward.
Okay.
Yeah, so step and boom. Take it down.
Take it down, forward.
Take it down, baby. Boom and down. Then step with the left leg now. Boom and down. Yeah? So you got it?
Yeah.
Go for the top. Go for the top. Five and then six.
Oh, wait, how fast?
One and a down and a two and a down.
Okay.
Yeah. Got it? Mm-hmm. Five, six, and seven, and eight, and one. Down, two, and down. Cool?
Yeah.
So now, so you go one and a down and a two and a down. Take it back, take it back.
Oh, okay.
Five, six, and a seven, eight, and go one, and down, and a two, and down. Take it back, and up. You want more?
Yes.
You sure?
Yes. More faster.
So cool. So we go. So okay, again, I'm gonna teach you that again from the top.
Okay.
I forgot everything I just did.
One.
Okay. So, one and down.
Wait, slowly. We got that part. We can't hear. Let me hear me coughing.
So we go. One. Two and a down, rowing one, two, three,
and
four.
Uh-huh.
So that's first step. So you turn to the right, so you open and close. Where am I foot? Yeah.
Open
and close. And open and close.
Wait, how did you turn?
So I just went, so we open and close, put down right foot, and this time
open
and close. Yeah?
Okay.
Put it all together. Mm-hmm. And bye. And six and seven and eight. Go and step and down. And
no, sorry, I was doing too fast.
Yes. Five and a six and a seven and eight. Go and step and down. And step and down. Take it. One, two, three, four. And open and close. And look. When you come here, you go one, two, three. Four, this turn takes like, yeah, you put it up, so you open and close, and open and close. Yeah,
we gotta get perfect one time and then we can finish.
Yeah, at least hold.
So, okay,
five and a six and a five, six, seven, eight, and a seven.
Everything, you know it. King already, you know it.
And down, step and down, going one, two, three. Four, release, contract, and release, contract. You're gonna remember the foot in front. You keep on stepping back, right? Your right foot. So right foot remains in front. Yeah. And yeah.
Let's say that was perfect. Thank you, Kimal,
no
for teaching us this lovely dance. We will practice at home, and we feel blacker already.
Okay.
And that's a wrap for episode 9 of The Nest. Stay tuned for episode 10 entitled Spring Cleaning, where we talk everything, you know, woosah for our mid-semester break.